Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making peanut chews. I'm still working on some party treats for you, and I'd like to have a few things that are sweet. Some of you like to have those occasionally, so let's get into making our peanut chews. We start with a pot that we can take to the stove, and we're going to put one stick of butter. This is actually one whole stick, it's just in two parts. That's 1/2 cup of butter that we'll be putting in our pot. Then we need some white syrup. This is called Bob White Crystal White Syrup. And I've measured out 3/4 cup. So here we go. Try to let all of it drizzle in there. And then we're going to put sugar. So this looks pretty buttery and pretty sweet, but you'll see we'll have something to fill it out after a while. I have 3/4 cup of sugar. I'll put that in. These three items go to the stove. So we're going over to the stove, and I will turn this on to medium and bring it to a boil, and I'll boil it for 2.5 minutes, and then I'll see you back. Candy beginnings are ready. You can see that it's boiling up nicely. It's been 2.5 minutes. And I have stirred pretty much continuously with this little wooden spoon. Now I'm going to add some vanilla. I have some vanilla extract right here. And I've measured out 1 teaspoon. So here this goes. I almost stirred that in. It's kind of making it bubble up a little bit. And then I have peanut butter. We have 3/4 cup, and I happen to choose a reduced fat variety using any kind of peanut butter, but I prefer the creamy for this, it works better, but you can use the chunky if that's what you have and that's what you want to use. So we'll put that in and we'll mix this around a little bit before we go on, because we're going to add another ingredient, and it will be kind of hard to incorporate that last ingredient if this isn't of a single consistency all the way through. So let me just stir this and see if that hot, buttery, sugary mixture will kind of break down our peanut butter. It'll be a minute or so before this happens, so I'll come back when we have this all blended together and we'll put the rest of our peanut chews together. This is what our peanut butter mixture looks like after we've combined our peanut butter with the cooked mixture, which was composed of syrup, sugar, and butter. And it's looking like candy. In fact, it's got kind of a dull look to it. That means that it won't take much for it to set up. In fact, we're going to add some cereal. And the cereal that I've chosen is a Special K. It's a Kellogg's brand. And it happens to be Chocolatey Delight. Actually, we had this on hand, so I decided to use that. You can just use regular Special K. That's fine. You can use any brand of cornflakes if you want to, or a similar brand, or a similar type of cereal. It could be wheat bran if you want to. Raisin bran would be okay. But this happens to have chocolate in it, so if you have cornflakes, then you could just put some chocolate chips in it if you want to do that. But this has the chocolate incorporated with the Special K cereal. I need 4 cups of it. So what I'm going to do is put my 4 cups in a large bowl and pour our candy sauce over the top of it and then mix that together. And you have a couple of choices once you get this mixed together. You can either quickly put spoonfuls out on a pan that is lined with wax paper and then let those cool. But as I said, it would have to be quickly because they will cool quickly. Or you can use the second option, which is the one I'm going to do. After I get this combined, I have a pan here that I have sprayed with canola oil, or use any kind of vegetable oil that you want, just a cooking spray. But once this is combined, then pour it into that greased pan. and you will need to press it in either with a big spoon like this or with your hands, but that candy is still kind of hot. But get as good a coverage as you possibly can before you start pouring it in. And this is just about as good as I'm going to get. And it may melt the chocolate. You may find that there is melted chocolate and then there are some chocolate chunks. It doesn't really matter. It's going to taste good anyway. So let's go ahead and get this out. This is kind of a heavy bowl, but not too bad. And we just want to spread it out in the pan. And then the next step is to let it cool. We'll cut it into squares eventually so it'll look nice for serving, and you'll be able to put it on a serving platter. And I think that's a little neater than just going with the spoonful technique, but it's your choice. If you want to get those individual pieces by spooning them out, that's fine. But you can see what's going to happen here is if I can get this pressed down, and I'm going to try to avoid using my hands, if I can get it pressed down, then we'll just walk away from it and let it cool. And then we might want to refrigerate it a little bit before we cut it into squares. But it's going to stick together. Even if you've missed a little bit here and there, it will give you some nice squares of candy. And I think you'll enjoy eating this. It's going to have a combination of peanut and chocolate taste. Unless you leave out the chocolate, which is fine, then it will just be peanut chews. And that's what it looks like at this point. So it's ready to cool, and I'm just going to let it sit here for a while, and then I'll have it in the refrigerator probably for a while, and then I will make cross cuts and then in the opposite direction so that I have squares to show you. Our peanut chews are ready. I let them stay at room temperature for a while, and then I put them in the refrigerator, and it's been probably a couple hours. You probably don't need to let them stay that long, but it is helpful to have them set up. What I did when I was cutting these, this is a 9-inch square pan that I have them in, and I think the size they should be is such that there would be 16 of them, and I just went down the middle in one direction with a knife like this, and then went down the middle in the opposite direction. That gave me four big sections, but it kind of marked off four territories where I could split this one in half lengthwise and this one in half lengthwise, and then just go crosswise and split them in half again. And that gives you equally sized pieces. If you just start over here and randomly move your way across in both directions, it doesn't quite work that easily. Now, getting these out, the first one is a little bit difficult to get out. So let's see what we have. That looks pretty good. So we're going to put that on our serving plate. And let's just get under the next one with a fork or whatever you like. But you can see what they look like. I'm going to go ahead and fill this plate and show it to you. The 16 squares of peanut chews were just right to fit on a nice serving plate, and I'm going to take one on my napkin as finger food, like you might at a party. I'll just pick this one, and there it goes. And if I take a bite, you're going to expect that these are chewy. Very good taste. A lot of peanut butter flavor. I got a little bit of chocolate, and that chewiness mainly comes from the cereal in there. It's really good. I think you'll like it.